it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. When I asked Coach J.B. Bickerstaff about Evan Mobley, he said his sole focus is, how do I help the Cleveland Cavaliers win basketball games? Play the game with that purity of heart, and then throw a skill set and intellect in. You've got a guy that impacts winning. He can do it so many different ways. Kevin?
He can. D.A., he's special. And thanks for your report. One thing that can be entertaining at this point of every season is how unexpected rivalries break begin to develop.
Teams that might not be traditional rivals have a few heated games early on, and now their matches become must-see TV matches every season.
Here's the starting group for the Cleveland Cavaliers. The defensive pair in the post, Mobley and Allen. Darius Garland is out there with Donovan Mitchell, and it's a Toro in a three spot. And for Indiana, the guard set will be Halliburton and Torche. Buddy Hield is out there with Diesel, and it's Turner in at center. Garland against Halliburton. From 10 feet out, and it's set back by Turner. Hogan with the rebound. Cleveland leading by five. Garland, and there's another one for the Cavaliers.
So hard to stay with off the bounce. Darius Garland, such a nice collection of pull-ups, floaters, you name it.
They grab their own miss. Shot's good by Turner.
Good way to start this game. You want to get him rolling as early as possible.
He's a guy, if he gets hot, he can carry your offense.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well.
The shot no good by Fortune.
Right now trying to get into a rhythm, but so far this quarter, Blake is struggling to make anything go down.
One easy look. Don't allow the defense to set up.
What a beautiful fast break opportunity. And the play is
pretty good. Yeah, that's exactly what he's looking for. Training. Triple.
It's stolen.
And he's with the that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnovers even more painful.
At the end of the day, though, it's 2 points. Don't hang your heads. Let's get refocused and play with more patience.
Here's Mitchell. The Mason's making the shot. Shoots from the line. Does not find the target. That makes him 3 for 5. The Pacers trail by 4. Here's Torche. And it's good off the rim. And Torche. Isaiah's got his second bucket of the night. Mitchell wide open. And again, unable to change momentum. Here's Nesmith. And it is gone!
And the buzzer for one on the floor. Big time shot.
That's the perfect end of the quarter for them. You have no idea how much of an effect those buzzer beaters can have on a team's momentum.
A good game so far as we get into the first quarter. Pacers lead by 1. And don't go away. We'll be back with the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment.
Show some love and relax your hands.
Take a look at the Pacers' performance here, guys, and what are your thoughts?
Just stretching out the floor in that first, they had the defense scrambling.
And that was obviously the plan coming in. Now the big question, can they maintain that efficiency from range as the game goes along?
Here's Garland. Playing Memphis, he was nearly unstoppable. And Doris, these Pacers, the first full season after the big trade that came in last year.
And I think they felt like they had to do something to shake things up. They dropped off in production over the last 2 years. That was after an extended run of playoff appearances. So what you hope is a guy as strong as Tyrese Haliburton, the skill set he has, can have an immediate impact and start to raise your trajectory.
On the floor for Cleveland, getting going here in the second. The 4-5. It's LeVert in at the 3. And let's get your guys take out the hustle steps for Indiana.
Their defense has been so aggressive right out of the gate, wasting no time shutting shooters down here.
Yeah, something else they've done well for us. We got to do the defense. We're rolling through energy up. That's easy to do for 4 quarters.
Garland, the pass to Mitchell. Again, Mitchell will say.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing to fall.
And this is where you hope that you find something easy so you can see the ball go through the net.
Yeah, great outside shooting, really fueling this run.
So, timeout called here at the first. During the Sixers' process days, of course, they developed lots of undrafted players.
They certainly did. Yeah, look no further than a guy like TJ McConnell who entered the league in 2015. Philly allows TJ to learn how to play the lead guard position. He got plenty of minutes. He could play through his mistakes. And all that experience was huge for McConnell's game.
Ricky Rubio checked in for Garland. Drew Love's got his second bucket.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Indiana's ball. They're on a 12-4 run right now. The Cavaliers trail by 9. For for three. Mitchell denied once again. Responding at a 40% range. He's 3 for 10 now. Drops in the tray. Great ball movement there. We're now about 2 minutes into the second quarter. Mitchell outside. From the arc. It's rebounded by Indiana. Turner's got a serve. We're done with the game with that last one.
No doubt the fight's there. They are trying to battle that. That's a dozen straight points coming off the trip.
Pass to LeVert. Front past the arc. No good that time. And it's the baseline taking it the other way. It's a victory here for the home team. Last time these guys met.
And in the last faceoff against these guys.
There's a level of commitment that Miles Turner is showing on the glass right now. He goes hard to get rebounds and get an opportunity for the putback.
Here's Rook. Well, scored by Miles Turner. Now, that's good.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here, it is eye-opening.
Turner passes to Matthews. Turner's over the hook. And again, that's a big one.
They're tough to stop if you're the defense. They have just got locked in for three-point range.
Here's and Doris Regime's trying to establish culture and institutional values. What makes that possible? How does that work?
I think that begins from ownership through the front office and down to the coaching staff and finally to the players. But Kevin, we know this. It can't be just talk. Show me, don't tell me. You have to be accountable to your teammates and to the organization.
And they may be leaning a little too heavily on the three-pointer when there are better looks to be had inside.
Launches a three, and again, it's the Pacers from deep on the field goal.
Well, why did Donovan Mitchell win the dunk contest? Case in point right there.
And great camera work showing up on the AT&T 5G slant cam. And Cleveland again with the bucket.
Well, you love the activity out there. What a play. This guy is busy on the offensive end.
And McConnell gets it to go. McConnell's got 12 points now.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. That's their last 5 makes.
Halliburton has jumped in for Indiana.
First team foul. Substitution on the
30 seconds left in the first half. Here's Rubio. It's tipped. Stolen by Allen. One-on-one here. Stevens, and he uses the glass on the lane.
Okay, Jared Allen, we see you making that look for a big man. That's a pretty pass.
Halliburton for three, and the Pacers on for number three.
One thing we've learned in the NBA, the game is never over. So you've got to continue to score, continue to build your lead. Well, that possession to me highlights the importance of creating for your teammates.
And so it's the Indiana Pacers taking a 15-point lead into the break. And with as many three-pointers as they bring, it's easy to see why they're on the cusp of a blowout. And we'll be right back after this.
For your team.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Boy, a lot of energy in this arena tonight. The hometown fans getting after it. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaquille O'Neal's here. So is Kenny the Jet Smith. For the Pacers, the first quarter was pretty even. They ended the period holding on to a slim 1-point lead. They just exploded in the second quarter, grabbing the momentum and running with it. basket after basket, and they played stingy defense. Now they've got a halftime lead that's going to be very difficult to erase. What are your thoughts about the Pacers and how they're playing?
Well, they built this lead in large part because of the sharpshooters off the bench. The subs played a superb game. You get it? Superb. They played like stars.
Looking at Cleveland, Jack, your thoughts?
Well, with the way they struggled to defend the three-point line, it's starting to look like warm-up tools. They cannot be afraid to bring more defenders out high. They got to make life tougher on those outside shooters.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter. Get underway.
Here's Garland. The guard set will be Halliburton and Dwarche. Then there's Buddy Hield. Then it's Turner. And it's Nembhard in at the power forward position. So that's who Rick Carlisle starts the second half with. That was a second look at our Mobile One Drive. Amazing control on this one.
That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Growing up around New York City, Doris, Donovan Mitchell was around pro sports as a kid.
He sure was, Kevin. His dad obviously worked in baseball. Donovan spent a ton of time in big league locker rooms. And how about this? During the 2010 main decision for the World Series, Mitchell was actually in the crowd listening to it.
And here is Garland. At the time, Albert was able to get the triple. The Cavaliers shoot their second and third shots at the line right here.
And I think this is a strength of this team. Solid numbers at the line across the board. 77% collected.
The Pacers making a switch here. Recepts Jeff. Well,
that's a case where teammates are showing trust in you, and he comes through with flying colors.
Here's the pass to Allen. Allen with the jam.
One of Jared Allen's best qualities is his motor. That activity paying dividends with his scoring.
Halliburton for three. And the rebound goes to the Cavaliers. Allen's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. McCoy. And Halliburton throws it down.
Well, deliver the pass where your teammate can do something with it. Nice.
Halliburton for three. Good on the three-point shot.
Jared Allen's leg, and he does it nicely on the offensive glass right there.
Drains the 3-point lead.
And then this is the game plan for him. He's a big part of their floor space.
And right now, Greg, he is doing a great job delivering for this team. Productive and efficient. That's exactly right, Kevin. Think about it. His father, Winston Garland, played 7 seasons in the NBA. And while Darius has always wanted to follow in his father's footsteps, Winston will be the first to tell you that young one is already better.
Jetty Osmond, he's checked in for Okoro. Pass to Osmond. Here's Allen. Six that one from the post. Allen's got 10 points in the quarter.
Well, individually, he is doing everything he can in this 12-minute session, but he's just not getting enough help.
You allow good scores to get uncontested shots at the rim. No wonder you're losing.
To me, this is simply stated, been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all
two teams changing it up here.
Substitution on the court.
And so here's Cleveland. Now the Pacers with it. They're on a 14-6 run. Jackson with the bounce pass. Three-pointer heel. The Cavaliers pull it in.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
They get it back. Got a piece of it. Jackson deciding where to go with it. Passes up to Mathurin. Offensive rebound. Chris Jack. And there's the bucket. Staying with it on the offensive branch. Getting it done.
Second chance points always hurt. It's not enough effort to block out.
No doubt those extra possessions can really add up against you when you do not take care of the defensive glass. I'll tell you, individually, he is doing all he can. But right now, somebody's got to step in. Who is this guy?
A lot of three-pointers here today.
Cleveland's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Locked up there for Allen. And a 7-0 jam.
Well, that's a highlight play for Mr. Jared Allen. Nice pass from his teammate.
The Pacers shooting wonderfully up to this point, 67%. Jackson, that's good.
And I've been impressed with the unselfishness, but also getting guys the ball where they can do something with it.
And he has shown a terrific feel for how the defense is playing him and then taking advantage of that. Well, he's such a good athlete for a center. It's how he's able to succeed despite being one of the smallest fives in the NBA.
Chris Chen, no good. The Cavaliers have gone 8-14 on their shot attempts here in the third. Some pretty nice work. LeVert, the pass to Allen. And slammed on by Allen.
This guy is such a good all-around player. Caris LeVert sharpening his court awareness and finding his open teammates.
Jackson. Jackson's got 6 points.
I love the determination he showed there, getting himself into good position under the glass.
With the presence of mind to know just where the rebound was going to come down. Well timed. Halliburton for three. Knocks down the three ball.
Relentless from deep, and you see the defense trying to react.
Well, that's the whole point, isn't it? If you space the floor well enough, it's almost impossible for the defense to account for everyone.
Tyrese Halliburton has been on display for Indiana. They kept going to him again and again, and he delivered with a massive quarter. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And let's listen to head coach Rick Carlisle review the game plan with his guys.
Hold your ground. Hold your ground. Your job is just to stay in front of this guy. Don't go by.
Now preaching strong defense there, GA.
I mean, basic fundamentals. He doesn't want to see anyone on his team get burned on that end.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. So on the floor for Cleveland, we've got Kevin Love, and it's Osman in as a three.
And I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
On our AT&T 5G slam cam, you just saw an explosive highlight. Bounce pass from McConnell.
Taylor.
Good. And McConnell gets the assist. McConnell's got the assist tonight.
Yeah, they're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results.
Offensive rebound, and good that time.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Here's Taylor, and the Pacers are number three.
Three-pointers are killing them at this point, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
Garland kicks to Osman. Pass to Love. Wide open. And that one drops. Love's got 4 points now in the quarter.
He's a talented shooter. Love doesn't avoid the mid-range like others might.
Halliburton for three. Love grabs the board.
play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Wade misses.
Those are chances. Almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of it.
Great positioning on the putback.
Just in a perfect position to grab that rebound and then get the putback.
Harlan with it. Jacks up a three, and he's good on the three ball.
Wow, a lot of distance on that jumper by Darius Garland. Nice.
Here's Jackson, and the dunk by Jackson.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher. That's tipped, and they're able to recover. Wade dishes to Garland. And another shot. Wade, good.
What energy on the offensive boards. The defense can't match the effort, and they paid the price.
Here's Taylor, and the Pacers take on Taylor. And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game. How it's been going for the Pacers.
They made a point to protect the rim, challenging shots all game long, and the block total is off the charts.
Another thing I thought they did well was pressure. They forced a ton of turnovers, turned those opportunities into points.
And we've got an injury out of the floor. Very unfortunate as always, guys. Don't like to see this.
Yeah, it looks like he's in real pain. Definitely a concern right now.
Well, these are the moments that can be gut-wrenching for him and his team, right? Anytime you see an injury like this, certainly your heart goes out to him and to his family.
Smith comes in for Brissett, and Chris Duarte subbed in for Halliburton. Here's Osmond.
2 minutes remaining in the game.
Here's Lopez. That one doesn't drop. Indiana's gone 2 of 5 on 3-point shots since the end of the third quarter. And out of bounds, the Cavaliers will take it. 1:51 left in the fourth. Out left of the wing, and out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession.
That looks like a lack of focus. You've got to question what he was trying to accomplish there.
And looking at that replay again, just a big time block right there.
And a block like that sends a message. One that says, we're not giving up this lead.
The Pacers have gone 5 for 9 from the field in the final quarter so far. O'Connell, a 3-pointer, is right on target. To Stevens with the drive. That's in. Coming off an assist from Rubio. And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. You can safely say mission accomplished now for Indiana.
They enjoyed a big boost from the strong play of their bench.
The subs came in and did their job. Those points off the bench were key to their victory.
And so all the hard work here tonight. The win comes. They were 26 on the
year. And they will walk out of here feeling really good about themselves today, guys. A big win over a conference foe they'd split their previous 2 games with.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Wade's checked in.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs it right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Duarte passes to McConnell. Connects from 3-point range. McConnell's got a turnover in the fourth quarter for Indiana. And so it's Hanna with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Cleveland Cavaliers. Here's Osmond, and he gets it to go.
Nice touch there near the hoop.
Indiana's got 8 shots off from 3-point land and hit half. Here's Duarte, and Indiana, another three.
Chris, finishing strong. This is how you want to close things out.
No question. They've got hot at exactly the right time. Clutch play on a team level.
Here's Lopez. Good work defensively by Smith. 35 seconds left to play in the final quarter. He hangs in there and finishes in with second chance points.
And you can sense that these fans,
these players, they're ready to celebrate.
Well, for all intents and purposes, this game is over. Just a matter of time here.
Here's Neto. Jet shot, rejected by Taylor, and he gets it back. And that one's good. Austin. They are in complete control.
This is the ultimate definition of the zone. Everything they've done has worked.
That's Donato. This one for three. The kick out to Lopez. Passes to Austin.
They were pretty much dominant.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.